Thebes is the heart of the world. It's the heart of Africa. I believe that it's been a purposely hidden secret of healing and worship. It's the only place in the world with a lunar rainbow. It's got the purest air in the world. It's the heart. This is really the cradle. This is home. This is where we all come from. Absolutely, it was serendipity, but it was the end of a marriage and a return home. I knew I wanted to come back and live in Zimbabwe after having been away from there for 25 years. When I arrived in the falls, it was just like I knew that this was where I wanted to live.
We are going to meet one guy who is the preserving of African culture, especially the witch doctors. As a foreigner like me, it's a little bit, a little bit weird. So anyway, let's try. But he can explain you much, much more better than me. It's to cure, when these African guys was infected by AIDS, then sometimes they consult to witch doctors. Witch doctors is not only psychological leader, but also they do some prescription for the disease using their herb medicine. So sometimes I've heard from my ex-workers, when witch doctor the prescribed to cure the AIDS, they burned with firewood on their necks to cure the virus, Then finally they had no choice but to consult the doctors, medical doctors, to operate the burned area, So that was one of the shocking stories.
I heard of couch surfing 2 days ago when a filmmaker walked in and caught me with a towel fresh out of my bath. And since then I've heard nothing but couch surfing from people that I've met. I see the beginning of something. It may have 3 or 4 million users, but that's nothing. I think you're looking at eBay in 1995 when you look at couch surfing now. It's the answer. It's going to change the way that tourism is done for the better, of course. Africa is what Africa is now because the African people have lost their culture. They have no religion, but yet they do. Yet they do. It's just, it's never been written. I had a calling. I moved back to Zimbabwe. I have an ancestral connection to Zimbabwe that dates back to the first white explorer that came north of the Limpopo in 1829, 1839.
Livingston?
No, before Livingston.
Before, okay.
I believe that my grandfather discovered these falls 20 years before Livingston. He was a man by the name of David Hume, an explorer. And somewhere along the line, the penny dropped. The African people have forgotten their way of reaching God, which is their ancestral lineage. We came here from our parents. I'm a product of my mother and my father, and I'm the product of my grandfather, 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 grandmother, grandmother, grandmother. And all of those people until I get back to the Creator. So that's the African way, which was demonized with the advent of Christianity, but yet it's a way which works. So we're fighting an uphill battle against colonialism. There's a war, I believe, ultimately the war for your soul is a war between colonialism and culture. I used to be Robert Fowler. In the last 4 years, slowly I've transformed into something that's no longer Robert Fowler. But it's a lot closer to what I want to be. And having come through the corporate and the capitalist lifestyle at the high end of it, I now find that the further away from so-called civilization I can be, the happier I am. And Robert Fowler was a classical urban corporate money-chasing, woman-chasing, drinking somebody. Didn't know what he really wanted, didn't know what he was doing, just pursued the money ideal because that was what I was brought up to believe, that if I was going to be successful I had to make lots of money. If you take a map of Africa now and go right into the dead center of that map of Africa, you're going to find yourself right here where we are. This is the heart of Africa. Now bring the continents together again to how we were before Gondwana land, and you're going to find the heart of the world is actually right here where we're sitting now. The most spiritual place in the world, a secret, is here, Victoria Falls. I've traveled to Machu Picchu, I've traveled to the east, I've traveled around the world. I've never seen a place that the energy is as white as it is here.
Yes.
David Shakiwa Ngube, a Zipra war veteran, lost his leg in an attack by the Rhodesian forces in the 70s. I was one of the Rhodesian forces that was chasing him. I'm a Rhodesian war veteran.
Yeah, I lost my leg during the war in 1978. And then from there I was taken for my further treatment to Cuba. And then I was under medical treatment from 78 to 84. That's when I got my amputee. The moment I've been in hospital, right in Havana, Cuba, during my physiotherapy, I used to go for a bike cycling. Then when I came back here, I said it's necessary, and then I happened to continue.
I bike from Victoria Falls to Ange, 5 kilometers.
Every day?
Every day. 5 hours. Every day.
This is my country, this is his country, and yet this country is just ruined by corruption. Corruption at every single level, and everybody blames Mugabe. It's not Mugabe's fault, it's corruption's fault. The politician has got a white businessman partner. Every business here, its tentacles go back, if you follow it back, it all goes back to one place. The biggest single shareholder of British American Tobacco, Anglo-American, Anglo-Platts. Everything, British Crown. What is love? Love is all that there is. That's the only reality. If you decide to choose love, then you're actually in heaven. That's the creator. And we are all energy. We vibrate at various frequencies. The highest frequency is pure light. And if you can find yourself in pure light, that's love. Peace is the name, said my friend. Love and fear are the two opposites, the positive and negative. Every single emotion comes from either love or fear. You can bring it back down to that simplicity and work out whether you're on the right path or the wrong path.
This is turning into quite the adventure. Yeah, I didn't feel like I was ready to leave, but Neil and Bianca were leading here insistent that we had to go.
Do you have to go with me?
Robert invited me to stay.
Why not? As soon as you come. But you're welcome to come and stay.
For as long as you want.
Oh, it's like my house. Who would have thought this morning I'd be here?
Today our plan is to give you a tour of Victoria Falls and the people that have walked us. This is to wash your hands, because you're going to eat with your hands. With God's knives, of course.
How many wives do you have?
I've got 2 wives and 11 children.
Wow.
My first wife is having 1 child, a male, and my second wife is having 10.
Wow.
5 females, 5 males.
That's
so I'm grown up enough. As I've been saying that, you know, disability is not inability. All those children I'm having now, it's not to say they are my children, they are our children, so we need to take care of them.
King Solomon had 1,000 wives. God's wisest men had hundreds. King Mzilikazi had 200 wives. It's the original way.
But it's seeming more like they're accessories, not...
No, powerful men throughout time have always needed more than one woman. One woman cannot provide all the needs of a powerful man.
Going.
The satisfying two wives. I mean, one woman is like difficult enough.
Well, this is my opportunity also. And it's not to say maybe I did it for a purpose. And maybe if I am to go to a third, fourth, it will depend on its own. Because I'll be not marrying those wives for myself, as we've been talking of spiritual. Maybe there are spirits on me who needs more wife. I have to follow that procedure. And so simple.
Women especially feel that they're never happy until they've got their soulmate. But then once they find their soulmate, they want to own that soulmate, and he becomes then a prisoner.
That's the devil's cataract. That's society tells us that normal is white picket fence, husband, wife, happy family, one man, one wife, forever. And it just... You see, the principle of war, divide and conquer. And the people that want to control us understand that very, very, very strongly. And so how do you divide and conquer? You put people into tiny little family units. The last thing that the system wants to see is strong, powerful families. And that's what's required, strong, powerful families. The moment you lie, you go into the shadow. The moment you're in the shadow, you can be controlled. It's only when you don't lie at all that you can stand tall. Otherwise you... And every married family... I don't know. Listen, honestly, how many married men, how many married women don't have affairs? What is love? It has to be happiness or joy. If you're not happy and you're not joyful, then there's no love. But love is also truth, trust and respect. Love, trust and respect. You can't have one without the other. If you don't have trust, you've got no love. If you don't have respect, you've got no love. These days, I think women run, or believe they run everything in the society. They bring up their children, their men are pussy whipped liars.